हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। आई जेवियन प्रीति सिंह, फैकल्टी ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक कंट्रोल्ड ड्रग डिलीवरी सिस्टम, इंट्रोडक्शन, टर्मिनोलॉजी एंड डेफिनेशन एंड रेशनल एडवांटेज डिसएडवांटेज। सो इन लास्ट सेशन आई वॉज डिस्कस अबाउट द only the small part of the small introduction of the controlled drug delivery system. So in brief, in this session we will discuss introduction, terminologies, definition and rational advantage and disadvantage of the controlled drug delivery system. This topic belongs to the novel drug delivery system for the BPharm 7th semester. So now we move to the main topic of the introduction of the controlled release. Controlled release drug delivery system is capable of achieving the following benefits over conventional doses form. For a total dose is low and reduced GI side effect and other toxic effect. Reduced dosing frequency and better patient accepted and compliance. So less fluctuation in plasma drug concentration level and more uniform drug effect and better stability of the drug. So what is the main definition of the rationale of controlled drug delivery system? So the basic rationale of a controlled release drug delivery system is to optimize the biopharmaceutics, pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamic properties of a drug in such a way that its utility is maximized through reduction in side effect and cure or control of disease condition in the shortest possible time by using smallest quantity of drug administered by most suitable route. The immediate release drug delivery system lacks some features like dose maintenance and control release rate and site targeting, and ideal drug delivery system should deliver the drug at a rate dictated by the need of body over a specified period of time. So now we move to the medical rationale. What is medical rationale? Medical rationale is belong to the frequency of dosing and patient compliance and drug intake. What is the timing of the drug intake? Approximately 2 times in a day and 1 times in a day. For example, this is considered in the controlled drug delivery system. So the fluctuation of serum concentration and reduced side effect and sustained efficacy. So now we move to the biological rationale. Biological rationale is belong to the pharmacokinetic parameters. We will say about the pharmacokinetic parameters: absorption, distribution, metabolism, excretion. Is all four parts of the pharmacokinetics. It belongs to the biological rationale: absorption, distribution, elimination, and dose dependent bioavailability, drug protein binding and duration of action, half life, and margin of safety and disease condition. So now we move to the advantage of the controlled drug delivery system: improve patient convenience and reduction in fluctuation in a steady state level, and increase the safety margin of high potency drug and reduction in total health care cost. So disadvantage: decreased systemic availability and poor in vitro in vivo correlation, increased risk of toxicity, and retrieval of drug is difficult in case of toxicity and poisoning or hypersensitivity reactions is also occur in this type of drug delivery system. So now we move to the potential limitation. What is the potential limitation of the controlled drug delivery system? So delay in onset of drug action. Delay in onset of action means the sustained delivery. So sustained delivery is very slow release in the body of the human. So possibility of dose dumping in the case of poor formulation strategy. Dose dumping means for the drug frequency. Firstly, we will say अगर आपने कोई ड्रग ली मॉर्निंग में, मॉर्निंग के जस्ट 4 आवर्स बाद आपको दूसरी ड्रग लेनी है, और आपने जस्ट उसको 3.5 आवर्स में या 3.75 आवर्स में वो ले ली, तो जो बची हुई जो रिमेनिंग ड्रग है वो क्या करेगी, टॉक्सिसिटी कॉज करेगी, तो उस चीज को हम क्या बोलते हैं, डोज डंपिंग. पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ डोज डंपिंग इज अकर इन दिस टाइप ऑफ ड्रग डिलीवरी सिस्टम. सो इंक्रीज पोटेंशियल फॉर फर्स्ट पास मेटाबॉलिज्म एंड ग्रेटर डिपेंडेंस ऑफ जी आई रेजिडेंस टाइम ऑफ डोजेस फॉर्म एंड पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ लेस एक्यूरेट डोज एडजस्टमेंट इन सम केसेस. Cost per unit dose is higher when compared with conventional doses. Not all drugs are suitable for formulating into extended release doses form. So now we move to the classification of the controlled drug delivery system. Rate pre-programmed drug delivery system, activation modulated drug delivery system, feedback regulated drug delivery system, site targeting drug delivery system. So there are main classification of the controlled drug delivery system. Rate pre-programmed drug delivery system means the predetermined rate of the drug intake in the body. What is the kinetic factor? What is the kinetic reaction of the body after to take the medicine? So activation modulated drug delivery system, activation modulated active in the target site for the modulation of drug delivery system is belongs to the activation modulated drug delivery system. So feedback regulated drug delivery system, so that in this system we will follow the feedback regulated feedback mechanism follow in this case. So the site targeting drug delivery system, means that specific target, aapka koi specific part pe agar target karna hai, just for example cancer therapy. In cancer therapy mein aap jo hai ek target site pe hi interact karte hain. That is called as site targeting drug delivery system. So this is also the part of the continuous drug delivery system. So thank you. This is the complete session. This session is powered by the digital version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. And I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will resolve it your problem by the problem resolving class. Thank you. And thank you for the listening.